What's up, guys? Happy Sunday. I am Tara with Tara Simon Studios, and today's Throne Room Confession is all about grit. So grit to me is passion and perseverance for something long-term. Grit is not instant gratification. It is agreeing to go the distance no matter what the cost. And I believe that people that rise to the top versus those that do not have an added measure of grit. And I believe that grit is not also directly attached to your intelligence quotient, your IQ. I believe it's attached to your adversity quotient, your AQ. And what you do in adversity, right? A lot of people quit, they fold under pressure. They just say, you know what? I didn't really want to do that anyway. And they minimize the goal. But grit says, I set out to do this thing. And I don't care if a flood comes, a fire comes, adversity comes, scrutiny comes, financial problems come, fights come. I don't care. I am pressing on to the goal to which I have been called. I have had to grow grit in my life many, many times during many different seasons. And I just want to tell you that God often is more interested in doing something in you than he is in giving you what you want. So, you know, those prayers are great that say, God, just get me through this. I am pressing on, and doing that is great. But I also want to encourage you, while you are growing that grit of perseverance and passion, you also need to be kind of aware during the process of what's happening on the inside, like what needs to be removed or what needs to be added in order to make that grit stick. I remember a time in my life where I could barely pay bills, and I've told the story before about how the studio started, and I worked 7 days a week for a year straight, and they were long days, and some of them were travel days. I would sing in a band, and I would go all over the country on the weekends. I'd come back exhausted at sometimes 4 or 5 in the morning, and then get up that next morning and drive to a different state to coach people and drive back as I was building my business. And you know, I get where you are. A lot of you are in a place where you can barely make ends meet, and maybe the pandemic has really done a number to your financial health, your mental health, your family health. But that's the moment. In those moments, that's where grit comes in. And so if you're someone who's raising your hand today saying, I want and need more grit, you can get it. It's not just there for those who already have it. You can get it. It is a mindset shift where you say, just know, not today, devil, you know, just know. I don't care the immediate wall that I see in front of me. The wall may look high, but I know, I don't just think, I know that if I just keep pressing in and pressing on, that all I need to do is really shout and that wall will come down. But I have to continue to go around that wall. And there's actually a story, for those of you who know the Bible, that Joshua in the Bible, who fought the Battle of Jericho and the walls came tumbling down, you know, he actually didn't fight it at all. They just walked around this city that wasn't very high at all. I'm sorry, it wasn't very big at all, but it was very high. The walls were very high and it looked big because of how high the walls were. So I just wonder in your life today, what are the high walls that you're looking at? What is that thing standing right in front of you that is so insurmountable looking that you just stand still and go, oh my gosh, like I can't even imagine how I'm gonna get up and through that. Well, maybe you don't have to at all. Maybe you just have to keep walking. Maybe you just have to keep persevering. Maybe you just have to shout at it and say, what I see in front of me has nothing to do with how I'm going to continue operating forward. That's grit. One more story for you. I was in high school and I was one of the leads in a chorus line. I was the girl, I was Deanna Morales, and I sang What I Did for Love and had a very big dance role in it. And I dislocated my left patella in a rehearsal, and it was bad. I should have gotten arthroscopic surgery, to be honest, but I never did because I was in the show. And they got a dance double for me, but I was bound and determined on the last show to do my dances. and with like a flexible brace cast, I went out there and I did it. And I remember the dance instructor saying to me, and it was the first time someone ever said this to me, he looked me in my eyes, because I was in a wheelchair backstage, and I got up and I went on the stage, and against their will, I told my dance devil, I'm like, you're not going out this time, I'm going out. And I did, and I remember the dance instructor, his name was Mr. Satinoff, he looked at me and he leaned in on the sides of my wheelchair and he looked me in my eyes and he goes, you've got grit. And I was like, what the heck is grit? But now I know. And if you're looking at yourself in the mirror and you need to look yourself dead in the eyes and say, you've got grit, speak it over yourself. Affirmations are real. And I know that I have grit because it's something that's been born in me, instilled in me, and grown in me. And so even if it's not a natural quality of yours, I'm telling you right now today, like Mr. Satinoff did, you've got grit. You can grow that. You can do that thing that you thought you couldn't do. Do what scares you today and don't stop doing it until you see your goal accomplished. I hope you're encouraged. I hope you're inspired. Let me know what you're afraid of in the comments box below and how you're going to use grit to overcome it. I'll see you guys in the next one.